What did Gladys Berejiklian know, and why did she keep her relationship with Darryl Maguire top secret, even after he'd been exposed as corrupt? These are the key questions the ICAC promises to investigate, with the first day of the inquiry revealing explosive private evidence Ms Berejiklian gave while she was still Premier.
Gladys Berejiklian marching to her Northbridge electorate office, and it's a fair bet she was going in to watch this.
This public inquiry will investigate whether Ms Berejiklian exhibited those high standards of probity that she set for herself and her ministers.
On the opening day of the ICAC's inquiry, they played private evidence that Gladys Berejiklian gave to investigators a month ago. Did she know about what her former boyfriend, Darryl Maguire, was up to?
At that point in time, you suspected that Mr Maguire had been engaged in corrupt conduct?
I didn't know. I couldn't make any assumption at that stage. He was professing his innocence.
This was Gladys Berejiklian as Premier being grilled 2 weeks before she resigned.
Well, what I'm asking is whether at that point in time when you asked Mr Maguire for his resignation, whether you suspected that Mr Maguire had been engaged in corrupt conduct.
I didn't know.
But ICAC wanted more.
I'm not asking whether you knew. I'm asking about the state of your suspicion or otherwise. Did you at that point in time suspect that Mr Maguire may have engaged in corrupt conduct?
No.
The ICAC questioning whether that was a lie.
Commissioner, an issue arises as to whether this commission should accept that evidence just played.
The commission made it clear they're looking at whether Gladys Berejiklian breached standards by not disclosing to both Mike Baird when she was Treasurer and then her own cabinet that she was dating Darryl Maguire.
Ms Berejiklian never gave a disclosure under the New South Wales Ministerial Code of Conduct in relation to Mr Maguire.
The key to the inquiry whether, by keeping quiet, she allowed or encouraged Darryl's alleged corrupt conduct.
Ms Berejiklian made or participated in the making of decisions and took other steps that advanced the building projects advocated for by Mr Maguire.
Those building projects won the approval of $30 million in taxpayer cash for the Riverina Conservatorium of Music and a $5.5 million grant to the Australian Clay Target Association in Wagga Wagga. And that project in particular was in the sights of today's first witness, a top official with the Office of Sport.
There wasn't any real design work. There was no way of knowing that the costs were right. The government could put all this money into something, but we had no idea whether or not it would be delivered. It didn't stack up. It didn't make sense.
The sales pitch was spend the millions on the Wagga shooting range so it could become a venue for the 2018 Sydney Invictus Games. Enter the chief salesman.
A great infrastructure addition to Wagga Wagga.
Darryl Maguire talking it up big time in the local press, but there was one problem.
Invictus Games doesn't have shooting events. So it was the claim that this was somehow related to the beef was imaginative.
ICAC believes it was Gladys Berejiklian's support which secured the funding.
There will be evidence to the effect that a number of public officials would have acted differently had they known about Ms Berejiklian's close personal relationship with Mr Maguire.
ICAC is under enormous pressure to satisfy the public that this wasn't just a relationship gone sour or a mistake with disclosures, but Gladys Berejiklian's conduct was bad enough to warrant her removal as Premier of New South Wales. And she's not mucking around, enlisting one of the heaviest hitting silks in the country to protect her reputation. Brett Walker SC, who charges up to $30,000 a day. Former Premier Mike Baird will give evidence on Wednesday, Minister Stuart Ayres Friday, and former Deputy Premier John Barilaro next week. A star-studded inquiry commanding the state's attention. That will ultimately culminate in the headline act, Gladys Berejiklian, taking the stand herself. Chris O'Keefe, Nine News.
Our state politics reporter Liz Daniels is at the commission for us tonight. Liz, have we seen a smoking gun as yet?
Well, Pete, there's still a long way to run. As of tonight, ICAC has exposed another one of Darryl Maguire's dodgy dealings. He advocated for a project which simply didn't hold water. But a local MP lobbying for money to be spent in his electorate is not groundbreaking. If ICAC is to prove corruption, it will need to prove that Darryl Maguire benefited from the build, that Gladys Berejiklian knew about it, and that she helped to push the deal through. One man that may be able to help join some of those dots is the then Sports Minister, Stuart Ayres. But Pete, for those answers, we have to wait until Friday.
OK, Liz, thank you.